The biggest disadvantage of creating VARRAY inside a PL/SQL block is that its scope is limited only to the block in which it is created. In this tutorial, you will learn how to overcome this disadvantage of PL/SQL collection VARRAY. What's up internet, I am Manish from RebellionRider.com and today in this PL/SQL tutorial, we will learn how to create a VARRAY as a database object in Oracle database. So without wasting much of your time, let's start the tutorial. But first, I request you to give this video a like because it keeps me motivated for making more such videos. And if you are new to the channel, then please do subscribe. Let's see if we can reach 100 likes on this video. Anyways, that being said, let's move ahead. VARRAYs created as database object can be saved onto the schema and can be reused. They have wider scope than those VARRAYs which are created inside the blocks. You can use such VARRAYs not only inside the PL/SQL blocks but also with other schema objects. So let's see how to create VARRAYs as database object. Start with creating the VARRAY. After setting the server output on, next we created a VARRAY with name dbobj_vry using create type statement. This VARRAY is capable of holding up to 5 elements of number data type. I have discussed the syntax for creating VARRAY as database object in tutorial 54. You can find its link in the description. Next, we will create a table and use our VARRAY to define the data type of the column of the table. But first, let's execute this query and create this VARRAY. VARRAY created. Now, let's create the table. Here, I have created a table and named it calendar. This table has two columns in which the first one called day name is of varchar 2 type whereas the second one named day date is of VARRAY type. Now, you must be thinking, what does defining a column of a table as VARRAY type means? Good question. Defining a column of a table as VARRAY type means that it can hold n number of values into it, where n is equal to the size limit of that VARRAY. In our case, the size limit of VARRAY is 5. That means the column day date of table calendar can hold 5 values. You will better understand this when we will do some practical demonstration. So let's move on. One more thing. Have you noticed that here we don't have any store as clause as we used to have with nested table collection to specify the external storage table? This is because unlike nested table, VARRAY does not require any external table for its storage. Rather, VARRAYs are stored in line with their parent record as raw value in the parent table. Anyways, let's insert some data into our table. This insert DML statement will insert a row into the table calendar. As you can see here, inserting data into the first column day name, which is of varchar 2 data type, is easy. You just have to write the desired data and enclose it into single quotes. But same is not true with the second column day date, which is of VARRAY type. In order to insert data into the column which is of VARRAY type, you first have to write the name of the VARRAY and then write the data which you want to insert. Also, you have to make sure three things. First, the data that you are supplying must be enclosed inside the parentheses. Second, the data type of the data must match with the data type of the elements of your VARRAY, which in our case is number. Third, the number of elements you are inserting into the column must either be less than or equal to the size limit of the VARRAY. In our case, it is 5 and we are inserting 4 elements into the column, which is completely okay. But if suppose I insert 6 elements into the column, then there will be an error. Let's execute this insert statement. But before that, we have to put a forward slash here so that compiler can easily differentiate between these two statements. Great, let's execute now. One row inserted. That is how we insert data into the VARRAY. Next, we will learn how to retrieve data from the VARRAY. We use our old and trusty to retrieve the data from the table, which is none other than the select statement, such as, let's close this script output first. Yep. This will retrieve all the data from the table calendar. Let's execute. As you can see in the result, that data which is retrieved is weirdly formatted. If you want to display the data, especially the data from the column which is of VARRAY type, into relational format, then you can take help of the table expression. Let's see how. First, close this query result and make some space so that you guys can see. Great. Here we have our select statement. For those who haven't watched my tutorial on select statement, let me tell you. Tab1 and VRY are two aliases, where Tab1 is alias for our table calendar and VRY is alias for the table expression. This means we are retrieving the values of column day name from calendar table and values of column day date from table expression. The table expression can open the collection instance and represent the object rows in relational format. If you want me to do a video on table expression, then leave a comment on this video and let me know. Meanwhile, let's execute the above query and see the result. Here is the result. Head over to my blog for an in-depth knowledge of VARRAY as database object and also to learn how to update a VARRAY. I think you know where you can find the link. That is the tutorial on how to create a PLSQL collection VARRAY as database object. If you enjoyed watching, then give this video a like. And if you are new to my channel, then subscribe. And don't forget to share this tutorial with your friends on your social media, because that helps others in learning as well as help me and my channel in growing. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.